Hello friends, in this lecture we are going to learn about public key cryptography. Okay, so till now we have learned about symmetric key cryptography. In symmetric key, basically if we have a message M, then we encrypt it with the same key, and at the receiver end he also decrypts it with the same key. Okay, so when you apply the same key twice, you will get the original message. So request sender receiver, they should be agreeing with a shared secret key. Okay, so that if I write something, it will be encrypted message which cannot be understood by others. But the problem is how to agree on a key in the first place, particularly if we have never met. Okay, so let's try to see. So there a new kind of cryptography was introduced that is known as public key cryptography. Here the sender and the receiver, they don't share a secret key. So the sender and the receiver, they don't have a shared secret key, but what they have, there is a public key and there is a private key. So the private key is known only to the person myself, okay, but my public key will be known to all of the other people in the world. Okay, so public encryption key is known to all. Okay, so people, if they want to send message to me, they will use the public key which is known to all to encrypt my message. Okay, but that encrypted message can only be decrypted by me, who has the private key, okay, for decryption. So this is the important thing here. So let's try to see now. So this is a plain text, okay, and let's say this is Bob. Okay, so Bob, so Alice is there and Alice wants to send a message, okay, to Bob, but she is writing some secret love message and she does not want others to read it. Okay, so Alice does not want others to read her message, so I love you, okay, but she wants that this should be encrypted to something like $#, something like this, so that even if someone reads this letter or message, it's not known. So what she will do, she knows the public key of Bob. Okay, so public key of Bob is denoted by KB plus, which is the public key, and the private key to decrypt that message is there only with Bob. Okay, so this message $?:OP, the encrypted message cannot be read by anyone else except the person who has the private key KB minus. Okay, so KB plus, the shared public key, is known to all, but the private key is not known to anyone else except Bob. So Alice sends the message, okay, so message M, she encrypts it with KB plus. This is the encrypted message, $?, etc., and this is received by Bob. Now Bob, when he applies the private key, he can now decrypt this message and it becomes M. Okay, so he can only do that. But let's say if Trudy, the intruder, has that message and she applies her private key, so this is for Trudy, so if she applies this on the message, then she will again get something $?, okay, which is not equal to M. Okay, so she cannot read the actual message. So this is public key cryptography. So what are the properties? Public key encryption algorithm. So we have requirements that we should have a KB plus, a public key and a private key, such that you can encrypt with the public key, but only the corresponding, the authentic receiver can decrypt the message and it will become M. So given a public key KB plus, it should be impossible to compute the private key. That is also important, because everyone is having the public key for Bob. So it should not happen that I can guess the private key from the public key. Then what will happen? Everyone can decrypt this message. So these are the two requirements for public key encryption. And this way you can encrypt. And one of the most famous public key algorithm is RSA algorithm, which was developed by Rivest, Shamir and Adelson. Okay, so let's try to see this algorithm.